There's a new initiative that we have engaged in. It is focused on the Kawuneeche Valley. It's where the Colorado River flows from Rocky Mountain National Park into Shadow Mountain Reservoir.
The goal is to preserve and protect the characteristics of this region. This process of change and restoration is something that's very welcoming.
There's been a loss of equilibrium between the local wildlife and the geomorphic processes that take place symbiotically.
It's a huge opportunity to bring back biodiversity and hydrologic functioning to that ecosystem.
Now we have an opportunity to work with the community and work with multiple agencies to effect real change.
The Kawuneeche Valley is the homeland to 9 tribal nations. I'm really excited to get their perspectives on the projects.
The Kawuneeche restoration effort is a multi-level collaborative approach to reestablishing some ecosystem services within the Rocky Mountain National Park.
We have identified a few sites in Rocky Mountain National Park, but we're also looking to implement projects on a watershed scale, looking at projects outside of the park on private lands or other federal lands.
I've done research on the west side of Rocky Mountain National Park for 33 years, and during that time I've seen the increase in moose population and elk population and willows that went from being 10 to 12 feet tall across the whole valley with beavers present to actually almost the extermination of willows.
There's a large ungulate population that has expanded over the years. They're now very well established there. They browse on willows, and as a result of that, beaver that used to inhabit this valley have been extirpated.
And so without willows, there's no beavers. Without beavers, there's no hydrologic regime to support the floodplains. And so the area has dried up and the vegetation has changed dramatically.
Beaver dams cause overbank floodings that create green areas that are beneficial in case of fires, for example. They create natural fire lines. If we could restore some of these dynamics, allow for some of these natural ecosystem balances to come back into place, we'd have a healthier and more resilient watershed.
Those ecosystem services include water quality. It helps keep our rivers cool, healthy for trout. It helps keep the right kind of aquatic insects and growth that we want. Overall, it's just a much better proposition. I think it's wonderful.
The goal is to reconnect the rivers and streams in the Kawuneeche Valley with the floodplain and restore some of the wet meadow habitat that Rocky Mountain National Park is known for. So this is really a long-term initiative. The collaborative started with a watershed scale assessment of the Upper Colorado River.
The first thing is to try to understand where the biggest changes have occurred, particularly if there's ditches or channelization or erosion that has downcut and lowered the water table. Those are the kinds of changes that are easy to address.
We're trying to collaborate and work with some natural low-tech restoration techniques.
So we're hoping to use things like simulated beaver structures, planting riparian vegetation, exclosure fencing to keep out the elk and moose from the areas. We're still in the assessment phase. What the next step will be is to seek the approvals and get the proper permitting and clearances needed to actually implement.
Northern Water reached out to the Colorado River District prior to the East Troublesome Fire. With the recent East Troublesome Fire, it's even more imperative that what gets reestablished is more appropriate to the natural environment.
The collaborative was in its formative stages in the early part of 2020. We were in the process of seeking some funding when the East Troublesome Fire blew through Grant County.
The East Troublesome Fire is definitely going to complicate these efforts, but it's all the more important now.
And as we move into the future with projections of expanding droughts and wildfire frequency, it's going to be really important that our riparian willow ecosystems keep water on the landscape and help us adapt to climate change.